As we've discussed in other videos, there is a waiver application that we can apply for, or you can also watch our video on humanitarian parole. However, there's a few key things that you can look at to see if you even need to go to take those steps. Now, in order for an individual to be granted access to the United States, there's a few things that need to happen, and one of those is the crime itself. If you were 18 or younger than 18, I should say, that those cannot be considered against you. You won't be considered inadmissible if the offense occurred when you were a teenager, let's say 16 or something. It's all offenses that are 18 years of age and older. If you've committed a crime more than 5 years prior to the date of the application, so if 5 years have elapsed since your entry into the United States, it is possible that we still would still recommend that you apply for a waiver, but your chances of getting entry into the United States significantly increase based on the fact that 5 years have elapsed and you've not reoffended. Committed a crime that does not exceed 1 year of imprisonment, obviously would, if the crime itself, not the fact that you yourself were not in prison for 1 year or more, but the crime itself does not have a prison term of 1 year or more, then your chances of getting the waiver applications or getting admission into the United States increase substantially. So it's not, and this is where a common mistake happens, it's not how long you have to serve prison time, it's if the offense itself is something that has a sentence of 1 year or more. So we have to look at that and interpret that to the U.S. Criminal Code. And also, been convicted of a crime but not sentenced to imprisonment for more than 6 months. Now, this applies to the applicant itself. If you were convicted of an offense and your prison time was only a couple of days, so long as it's less than 6 months, then your chances of getting admission to the United States or getting the waiver application approved also increase significantly. It is when it is 6 months or more when the chances reduce a little bit and we need to work on ample documentation to prove to the CBSA officer that you're not going to be a risk to the citizens of the United States. If you have questions about entering into the United States or applying for a waiver, give us a call today. We're here to help.